Binding the date picker to the worksheet cells is very simple. You only need a single code. On your VBA editor, on the Project Explorer, double-click on this workbook as I do right here. On the object drop-down list, select workbook. On the procedure drop-down list, select the sheet selection change event. Within this event, you only need to write datepicker.findDateRange. That's it. You can now go back to the workbook and do your business as usual. The datepicker is intelligent enough to figure out whether you need a time picker or a date picker. Let me show you. Right now, every cell in this worksheet has a general date format. If I change the format of this column to a short date, I will get a date icon when I click on any cell in this column. If I click on the date icon, I get a date picker, and if I select a date, the date will be applied in the specified cell format. If I want to make this a long date, I will go there and change the format to long date. Now if I select a date, the date will be displayed in the format specified. My long date appears with the day name because what you select in the drop-down menu or this format cell window under the date category is based on the system settings. Mine includes a day name. While we are here, let's select a time format and see what we get when we click on any cell within our target column. As you can see, this time we get a time picker because we are dealing with time. If I press the apply button, the time will be applied in the format specified. What about custom formats? It's simple. On the format cell window, go to the custom category and select any default date or time custom format, or specify any formats and everything will work just fine. You might be asking yourself, will this date picker override my calculated dates? No, this date picker will ignore any derived date. As you can see, in this report, this date is derived by a formula, but these ones are captured. The date picker knows the difference. If I click on any of these cells, I get a date icon, and with it, I can select a new date. However, if I click on this cell, the date icon stays away to avoid an override. So by default, this date picker will avoid any date or time derived with the formula. However, if for some reason you want to override formulas, you can go back to the VB editor where we wrote our findDateRange method, place commas until you get to the ignore formulas parameter, and set it to false. Now if I go back to the worksheet, the date picker will also appear on dates derived through formulas. However, as for me, I don't like this. So I will go back and remove the override. That's it. If you're watching this and you haven't downloaded this date and time picker, please use the link in this video description and navigate to my webpage.